Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of the Haunted Diaries. We are back here at Split Rock Quarry on the anniversary, July 2nd. I'm here with my friend Bryan.
Hello, I'm Bryan.
I'm Randy.
I'm Terry.
Nancy.
Beth.
Careful. You okay?
Yep.
Is this his or this was on?
Yeah.
Is it yours? I'll put it in here and then you can look later.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Yes. It's probably my phone case.
And of course, I'm Bryan. So today is the anniversary of Split Rock. on this day, 104 years ago, you had a fire start at around 8:30 from one of the machines overheated. They lost water pressure in some of their hoses when they tried to put it out. The result was a huge explosion. Killed, injured about 60 people. There were eyewitness accounts from people who lived near here that felt the blast that threw them off their feet. Buildings in downtown Syracuse shook. If anybody looks into Syracuse history, Split Rock, you can actually read about the explosion, some of the people's names that have been here. A lot of people up here have had experiences. Shadows, footsteps, EVPs, knockings. We have a little motion detection devices set up here, at, like little cat toys.
Yep, there's one right up there.
Yep. So a lot of the things people see here, a lot of the figures are yellowish tinted figures because when the explosion happened, there's a lot of picric acid that flew around and stained a lot of the workers' clothes that passed away.
Yeah. The white people were yellow. The black people were green. And people who come up here see these lights like floating in the tunnels out in the open areas and
no one. African Americans.
Yeah. Sorry. I'm African Americans. My bad. As I think I said in the last video, there's a marker for their like bodies up to Oakwood Cemetery.
Oakwood Cemetery has a big memorial. If you look in any online, you can see a picture of that memorial with some of the names. Now, this was actually a ammunitions factory. It was originally a stone quarry, and it got switched into an ammunitions factory during World War I. On the other side of the valley that's over here, you had another factory called Canada Dry. And that Canada Dry is where they used to store the gunpowder, store the ammunition, and thankfully none of that got sparked by anything. If anything would have gotten sparked over there by a fire, it would have caused a bigger explosion, which probably would have leveled the buildings in Syracuse. Thankfully, that didn't happen. But as far as paranormal activity up here, this is a hot spot, one of the hot spot places of paranormal activity here in Syracuse. And so we'll do we'll do a little investigation, and thank you for tuning in. And with some members of our group.
Yep. Hey, guys. Sorry about the bright light, but...
I'm blind.
If you're going to be here, I can be Sean's buddy here.
Yeah. I'll stay here and watch
the light. Ouch.
Yeah.
One time we came up here, we saw like candles in these little openings here. Ooh, is that a demon?
Ghost
Ocula. Careful.
That's me.
That was me.
That was the rock.
have an ovulus that I brought, so I'm going to turn that on.
Just nice.
Pretty.
Yeah. Hello?
Who's Margaret?
I wonder if I could set this down on the ground and then just have it filmed down there.
I get some like Indian light down here. Well, this is all fossiliferous limestone, so. What caused the explosion up here? Okay, I can hear birds outside. And bugs. Is there any members of the Krauss family up here? Just before you moved, I thought you heard something.
Begin.
What did I
say? Begin. Begin. Oh, begin.
Begin what?
Can you tell us your name?
Male or female?
How many of you are there here?
That's me. I'm back there.
Infant.
So there's a baby up here?
Baby crying? Is Margaret the infant's name?
And I'm gonna sit up here. Ouch.
That's me, my phone. Do you want us to break out some of the other equipment we have?
If you got to do it. Huh?
No, my phone touched my EMF thing.
Oh, okay. Well, the audio said potentially.
Potentially. Oh.
Yeah, thank you. Airplane going off. Airplane flying over is what I meant to say.
Yes, over here.
What? Yes, over
yes,
here.
Over here.
My fabulous never says it. Sure.
I know.
At the same time.
It's only one word.
Where are
you? Can you tell us what happened up here?
Oops. Where do you want me to put this? It's like a rain pad.
I'll put mine back by the crusher.
Okay.
We're actually in the... you mean back there?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Where do you want
that? If you want to put one up further, like where the my...
The light is?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry.
No, you're fine. I just don't trust myself going in the seat part.
Who do you hate?
Okay, I'm going to set up a light here. When I turn it on, if you come near it, it'll light up so that we know. See?
Yeah.
Can you come forward and touch that?
Okay.
Thank you. Did you guys see that?
No.
I walked away. I said, can you come forward and touch it? And it went off.
Nice.
Can you do that again? Just touch the light. All you have to do is just walk right up to it.
Yeah. So if you look right here, you can see the REM pod. There's one here, and there's one that's going to be set up somewhere back here. So.
Can you come over here and touch this again? It's right in front of the light.
Damn
okay,
kids.
Meet all of you. Can you do something so we know you're here? Touch that red flashlight or touch the lantern?
looks like. Fourth little alcove.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like someone like poked their head out. Two down from where the red flashlight is. Look like someone poked their head out. I'm hoping I got that. And it also looks like there's just one next to it. Down further. Hello?
We have a bulb. If you touch it, it'll light up different colors on that beam right there. It won't hurt you. Can you light it up for us? You.
Ouch.
Just lets us know that you're here.
There's a Brummett compass with me.
Looks like you have the same one I do.
What, compass?
Powerful.
Or? Now.
Same Brummett.
Oh. Now.
I'm just gonna see that.
Yeah.
You're good. Okay, so, it's said that compasses can be used as ghost hunting equipment too, because. It uses like the same EMF fields as like a K2 meter does.
What does that do?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's bald head. Yeah, him. He's the one who told me about this guy.
Yeah.
That I jumped.
I was reading the thing, and he said that he used to do it for years, and the prices of things are crazy, so he just builds them himself.
Oh, yeah. People. Yeah, he does.
Yeah.
He actually used to be a member of PAX.
Really?
Yeah, but he had, they kicked him out because of some, like, Parkinson's disease or some disease that he had. I'm guilty.
What are you guilty of? Yeah, the explosion was fatal. Blew up half of Syracuse.
I'm trying to think of, like, ways that this would actually be picking up, like, radio waves or something like that. Mm-hmm. Like, try to find ways to debunk it. I don't know. Because I'm trying to think what the only thing is with these apps.
Ouch. Hey, I'm at the 20-minute mark. I can take for another, like, 10 minutes.
This app was actually through a paranormal group that they made
No. Yeah, go for it. I'm just sitting in dirt.
This one's okay. Spirit talker.
Okay.
Do you want to
start
with this?
Careful, careful, careful.
Please come touch the lantern again. Nobody but me saw that when you did that.
Which one was Pat's?
Jason and Grant.
That was Jason and Grant.
Yeah.
He knows Jason and Grant. He wasn't popular enough on TV. He was kind of like an off TV.
What did it say?
Intense, fresh, kind of set. Our intent is we just want to communicate with you.
Sean, what did he say he had? Some sort of Kenny. What disease did he say he had? Was it like ADD or like Parkinson's? It was some sort of disease.
Yeah, I don't remember what he had.
Not even ALS, I'm not sure. But either way, he had this, he has this disease or this disability.
Are you somebody who is a victim of the explosion?
Whispering. Do you know anybody by the name of Kraus? Is there a Samuel Kraus that they used to work up here?
What were these tunnels used for?
Communicate.
Behind that shoe, if you're going on this, that huge one. I don't know how you it goes towards it.
Yeah, what's funny is that a relative of Sam Krause was taken up to Rolling Hills Asylum.
Oh, Roy.
Yeah. Do you guys knows anybody named Roy Krause? Does that name sound familiar?
William. Who's William?
SH plants.
What did it say?
Implants.
SH implants. Interesting.
William.
Stomach.
We lived close.
We lived close?
Did you... Crap, I gotta charge my light when I go home. Damn. It might be.
It might be.
Unless it's them trying to get our attention. Okay. Little crevice here.
Yep.
Is somebody trapped behind one of these walls?
Be fearful.
Be fearful? Nah, that's...
What should we be fearful of? That everybody feels so good.
Yeah, it does. It's coming down to 75.5.
Nice.
William, what street did you live on? Will you marry?
Never.
What did you do for a living?
Video.
Video?
They had video back then? I didn't know that. That's true.
Evelyn.
Hi, Evelyn.
Are you related to anyone who used to work up here? Who do I keep seeing poking at their heads on?
I just saw something too. The next one after the flashlight.
Yeah.
If there's someone here, can you light up a flashlight? Can you do something to let us know you're here?
Taylor.
I went to school with somebody named Taylor.
Is Taylor a name, or was that your occupation?
Devil. We don't want to hear that, sorry. Still can hear a bug flying around. Okay, I got like maybe 20 seconds left on my phone to tape. So I'm gonna stop this.
Stop this one video.
Yeah.
Thank you for tuning in. Please subscribe. Like, seeing why ghost hunters. Thank you for tuning with us, and happy hauntings.
Happy hauntings. Later. Peace.